All right, welcome everybody. It's Wednesday night yin. Sorry, I'm running a little late here. We are going to use some wall space later. We were just talking about that and arranging. So when it's time for us to go on the wall, I'll be back here. You guys will still be able to see me and what I'm doing, right? Which is the important thing. So find a place in your house, if you're watching this at home, where you're going to be able to get on the wall, right? And we'll just do a couple things. We're going to start on your mat, so don't worry about it right now. And if you absolutely don't have wall space that you can use wherever you are, I'll give you some other modifications and things you can do if you don't want to use the wall. Right now, just come to your back. Let yourself arrive. Take a couple minutes just to let your body calm and relax. Surrender to the yoga. This is yin. So we do a lot of surrendering. Right? We take these poses, common everyday poses. We hold them a little longer, we make them a little more. That's why I say we surrender to them. Right? Even when your body's fighting you at first, make it hold the pose, make it surrender. When I say make it hold the pose, it doesn't mean you force your body into some crazy position it doesn't want to be in. It just means that even when you want to come out of the pose, you stay in. Your body really gets the full benefit from it. Yourself focus on your breath, right? You have to control your breath yet here. You might not be able to yet. That's okay. Right? But just start to notice it. Notice what's going on with it. Get to that place. Where your breath is just pushing out all those distractions. It doesn't matter what Google had to say. What you're going to do when you leave here tonight, how many things are on your to-do list. It doesn't matter if your kids are never going to school again. I don't know, that's just me. Let all that go. Bring your full focus to your breath. Will push all those distractions out, so you can be focused on your mat, you can be present to your mat. And that's the important thing that we get from yoga, that full focus on our mat, that full presence on our mat. Now, we're ready to start moving here. What you're going to do first, right? Just take your knees, hug them in, let's go the other direction. We're just kind of waking up that spine a little bit. Starting to feel it. And then from there, take your hands to the crease of your knees. Just rock yourself up to a seated position. And we're going to move here a little bit at first. We're going to start with a little lotus flow. We haven't done that in a while. So we're going to come to easy sit. Now we're going to do it a couple times through. We'll move it the second time through a little faster. And we're going to switch legs the second time through so that we even out our size. Right now we're just going to stay. It doesn't matter which leg's in front, whichever one's more comfortable to you. As you inhale, sweep your arms up to the sky. And then as you exhale, just drop your right hand to your right side. Take that left hand, reach it up and over. Inhale, come back up to center. As you exhale, now you're going to go the other way. Drop that left hand down. Reach the right hand up and over. Inhale, come back up to center. Exhale, twist to the right. Taking the right hand back behind your hip, left hand outside your right knee, lifting over your right shoulder. And yeah, you're going to untwist. Come, bring your hands back up overhead. Then we're going to go the other way. Take that left hand back behind your left hip. Take your right hand outside your left knee. Put your gaze so over your left shoulder. Inhale, come back to center here. Take both arms up overhead. And then as you exhale, now sweep your hands back behind you. Back into your palms. Pull your shoulder blades together. Open your chest. Look up. So you're taking a little back bend. If you want to here, right, you can press your palms into the mat. Push your knees forward. Let your hips lift off the ground. You can totally skip that part if you want to. All right, now we're going to let our hips come back down. Back up tall, and then as you inhale, sweep your arms up overhead. Now turn your palms towards me, and as you exhale, just fold forward, bring your hands down in front of your shins, and walk it all the way forward. You want to keep your hips down on the mat here as we're walking forward. Maybe your elbows can come down to the mat. Maybe you can get your head down to the mat. Just keep your hips anchored to the mat. That's just going to give you that pull in the mat. Start to open them up. Take one more breath here. Easy sit. Right now we're going to do that all again. A little bit faster now, but we're going to switch our legs. So you're bringing your other leg in front, right? It's the awkward leg, that's what I call it, because it's the leg your body didn't naturally want to put in front. Right? But keep it in front here so it's even out those sides. If it doesn't feel quite as comfortable, right? Let yourself just feel that. Do the same movements. Inhale, take your arms up to the sky. Exhale, drop your left hand, or your right hand to your right side. Reach that left hand up and over. Inhale, come back up to center. Exhale. Drop your left hand, reach your right hand up and over. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, take your twist to the right. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, take your twist to the left. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, scoop your hands back behind you. Pull your shoulder blades together, open your chest, lean back. If you want to, push into your palms and lift your hips. Skip that if you want. Come back down, push all the way up. Sweep your hands up to the sky again. Turn your palms towards me. Drop your hands down in front of you and just walk it forward into your fold here. And again, you can drop your elbows to the mat and just reach forward, whatever feels good. In sync, right? So as you inhale, lift your chin up to the sky, tuck your tailbone under, let your belly drop. That's cat. Exhale, tuck your chin to your chest. Crawl with your armpits round your back. That's cow. And just keep moving here. Inhale into cow. Exhale into cat. Try to get that synovial fluid to flow through our spine and all our movements that we do tonight a little easier and a little more fluid. More rounds here. in our tabletop. Now, as you come to your tabletop here, tuck your toes under. Lift your hips up and back. Come into your first down dog here. Right? We're not going to stay in down dog super long. You're just going to bend your knees, look between your thumbs. Bring your feet forward again. So now I'm standing up. I'm going to turn towards the front of the room here. And here's what you're going to do here, right? You're in your forward fold. So your belly's touching your upper thighs. Your head's getting heavy and long. Bend your knees as much as you need to get your belly to touch the thighs. And more importantly, take your hands to come to the ground. Let your head be heavy, so you're shaking your head. Yes and no, making sure there's no creases in the back of your neck. Now, you're going to flip your palms over here, right? So this is why we've got down nice and low. So your fingertips point towards your toes. Maybe you stay right here. If you can, lift your toes up so you can slide your hands underneath your feet. Bring your toes toward your wrists, right? And then press down to the base of your palm. And let your elbows bend a little bit as you pull yourself further down. Call this gorilla pose. It's good for your wrists. Opening up your hamstrings. It's good for your back. So we're going to stay here for a minute. Four more breaths here. Then when you're ready, take your hands out from underneath your feet, just bring up to the tops of your feet, and just slowly don't roll yourself all the way up to standing. All right, now here is where we're gonna go to the wall. So I'm gonna take my mat back to the wall. I might move the camera up in a second. All right, once I get all the way set up back here. If you're watching at home, find a wall space now. If you're in the studio, find some wall space. All right, so you can break your mat right up against the wall. That's what I'm going to do here. Now, I'm going to try to move this camera up closer so you guys can see me a little bit easier. If it doesn't work, I might have to switch back, but bear with me. Let's see. All right. How's it work now? Can you see my mat? Can you see my mat? Can you see me? All right, yes, yeah, so that's a little bit better. All right. Christy wants to know that they still see her. They don't. It's all good. All right. So what we're going to do first, right? You're going to turn towards the wall. We're going to do that first couple poses standing. This first one, we're turning towards the wall. So this is basically like melting heart on the wall. So you're going to take your forearms to the wall, right? So your elbows are even with your shoulders. Fingertips are up towards the sky. You're going to start to step back. Keep your forearms against the wall. And just let your head drop in between your shoulder blades. The further back you step, the more sensation you get. You do want to keep your heels down, right? We're not trying to lift it up. Just keep everything down. Let your forearms hold you on the wall. So get that opening in your chest. Should our head touch the wall? Your head shouldn't touch the wall. Your head's dropping between your shoulder blades. Right? So your elbows are touching the wall, but your head's dropping down. I guess if you can drop your head very, very far down, below your shoulders, maybe the crown of your head will hit the wall, but it will be below your shoulders. Right, so move your elbows down a little bit, because they're even with your shoulders. There you go. Now push your butt back and come down. There we go. Okay, nobody can see you. Push it all the way back.
It's like so tight right now.
Four more breaths here. your butt should be touching the wall. If you can walk your heels back, your heels touch the wall. Right? See how it's kind of hard. It's a lot of work pressing everything back into that wall. There's always something that wants to come up, right? You press your head back, then your shoulders want to come up. You press your heels back, then your back wants to arch. Just see, right? Just take four more breaths here. See if you can press everything against the wall. From here, you're going to kind of relax now. You want to keep your heels and your glutes touching the wall. We're going to come into a forward fold, right? So you're going to fold forward. It's like, think about swan diving down. What's going to happen, right, is that you're going to want to tip over because you're trying to push your butt back and you can't, right? It's okay. Step away from the wall a little bit so you can put your glutes on the wall. Then come all the way down. So your hands come to the ground. Now, you should by now be able to feel your glutes into the wall. Maybe you can move your heels back a little bit. Once you're there, put your belly on your thighs, let the crown of your head go towards the mat. Right? So this is a different sensation. You're like, this is not as much fun as our regular forward fold. Right? But it's because we're trying to keep our legs straight. We're trying to get in the actual position that we should be in all the time. The more we're away from the wall, we get ourselves those little cheats. Now if you don't have wall space, right, I should have said this in the melting part, you can just be in a regular forward fold, right? See how it feels. But try to keep everything straight in your legs. You can put a little bend in your knees, like we always do. Okay. Try to get that evenness between your heels and your glutes. Three more breaths here. And then walk yourself a little bit more forward. Come all the way down to your knees. All right. So sit up here. You can just be in tabletop if this doesn't feel good to you. Get that upright position for a breath or two. Let your shoulders fall back and down. Push your shoulders down towards the ground while the crown of your head goes up towards the ground, trying to create as much space as possible between the top of your head and the tops of your shoulder blades, right? So you're lengthening out that neck. Here, we're going to come forward, right? We're still using the wall. So here's what you're going to do, right? You're going to come to your belly. And as you come to your belly, you want your knees to go back by the wall, right? So that your feet are up on the wall, right? I'm taking my feet a little bit wide here so that you guys can see how they are on the wall. But you want your feet kind of closer together. You want your knees and your feet about hip width. This is part for real, right? I took mine a little wider, just so you can see what the position of the feet should look like, all right? Then you're propping yourself up on your forearms, so your shoulders are right over your elbows, and you're looking up. Right, so this is basically Sphinx pose, but we're just using the wall, gives you that little extra oomph. Press your palms into the mat. You're trying to push the floor away from you. Feel this pull in your low back. Right, so your belly is down on the mat, your quads are on the mat. Pressing your shins and the tops of your feet into the wall as much as you can. Right, if your shins are starting to pull away a little bit, that's because you're letting your feet start to relax towards you, right? Pushing the tops of your feet into the wall. Even if your shins don't touch the wall, then at least you're still engaging everything. Now, I should, again, as you said this, is I promise I'd give modifications to people who don't have a wall. If you don't have a wall, then you're just in your regular sphinx. Right? And you can try taking your feet up to the sky and just bringing your heels back towards your glutes. If that doesn't feel good, rest them all the way down. Right? If you have the wall, it's easier to rest them against the wall. Ready, just let your hands come in toward your chest.
Let your one ear or the other come down to the mat, and then what you're going to do is you're just going to push yourself toward that ear that's down on the mat, so you're rolling over onto your side.
Okay, and then from there, we're going to come around. So we're going to do here our traditional legs at the wall pose, right? So the easiest way to get into it is you come, you sit with your hips against the wall, right? So I'm sitting sideways to the wall. And then I'm going to come around. I'm going to bring my legs up to the wall. Now, as I ended up here, my heels are on the wall. My legs are not on the wall. So I'm going to scooch my booty closer to the edge of the wall, right? Until the glutes are touching the wall. You can flex your feet and almost the entirety of your legs are touching the wall. You're flexing your feet, right? So it's basically waterfall with the wall as a backdrop. Now you guys are going to stay here for a couple minutes, right? I'm going to come out of it right now so I can show the version where you're not on the mat, I mean on the wall, and then I'm going to see if I can fix our music without Google going insane again, okay? But we're here. We're on the mat. Don't think about it in your stomach again, especially if she does an insane thing. All right, so we're here, and you're flexing your feet. So this is what you're going to do if you don't have wall space, right? You can just be right here. Your legs are pulling up. You're getting the same benefit. We're sending the blood from the femur and pulls all day, taking it back down to our head and our heart where you need it more, right? So you stay either there, just with your legs straight up in the sky if you don't have a wall, or if you've got the wall, you've got your legs back against the wall. Right, we're staying here for 2 minutes. So you guys stay right there. Will come at you while you're here. Let yourself lay still with it. It's so good for us, right, to use the wall as support just to get these feet above our head and our heart. Now we're going to take different variations of this pose, right? This is the basic one. We'll start to do some variations here in a second. All of them should feel good. It does feel kind of weird at first, right? Because you're in the opposite position where you usually are. Now your feet are up above your head. You're used to having your feet on the ground. Right, you guys are going to stay here for another minute. Alright, now, from our legs at the wall pose, right? What we're going to do here is we're just going to take our legs out wide. Right? So those of you in the studio, you've got plenty of space. So just let your legs fall open. Now you're going to keep them mostly flexed. You want your heels to be touching the wall. Your toes are going back towards your face. But as you lie here, right, eventually, legs are going to start to open a little more, a little more, a little more. Just let that happen naturally, right? You don't have to force it. If your legs aren't opening anymore, they're not. You feel them slide open. Resist the urge to bring them back closer together, right? You want them to open up as much as they possibly can. Head, hips, shoulders all on the ground. Just looking straight up at the ceiling. So now we're starting to open those inner thighs a little bit. Right? Your feet have already been straight up. So you've got that blood flow starting to go back towards your heart, towards your head. It's all good. Now if you don't have the wall here, I'll show you the version without the wall. You're just laying on your back, coming into that waterfall, and you're letting your legs open up wide. And sometimes this can be hard to hold for a while if you don't have the wall. You know, everybody's heels at least are resting against the wall. If you have that wall space, you can always use your hands for a little bit of support, right, if you need to. If you're trying to let them open wide, just staying even like they were on a wall, right? You don't have them with one heel in front of the other. You don't have them way back with your tailbone lifting. But just pretend the wall is there. Your hands for support if you need it. All right, we're going to take a couple more minutes here in this pose. I know that Heidi did the wall pose or did some wall poses in her Monday night class. I don't know if I'm doing the same ones. Maybe I am. Okay.
It's not every level.
I know. And you guys are probably like, why is everybody doing the wall poses all at once? Really, it's because of Chandra. That's what I say. She wanted to do wall poses. I said, okay, I'll do some wall poses. She said the same thing to Heidi. Heidi's like, okay, I'll do some wall poses.
Good job.
If you guys were all coming to the studio and you told me what you wanted, I would do it for you. If you're not in the studio, but you still want me to do a certain kind of class, then just send me a message or write it in the comments of this class. Be like, hey, Mom, I really love this pose. Put it next week. I will. I'll do it. I'll do it for anybody who's watching regularly. Anybody who shows up regularly.
Thank you. Thank you.
I appreciate it. But in the meantime, we're all still here in this wide-legged pose. Maybe you want to let your arms go out long to the sides. That feels good while you're here. Maybe you'll let your arms come up overhead. That's fine too. Just keep your shoulders on the ground, right? Keep your head on the ground. Maybe it just feels better to let your hands rest on your belly. All good options. We're going to give it another minute here. Here. You're going to start to bring your legs back together. Right? So you're going to use that regular legs up the wall pose. Right? Go back to waterfall if you don't have the wall.
Now we're going to go right from here into our bound ankle position. So what we're going to do here, you're going to bring your feet together and then drop your heels down. Now your knees aren't going to stay on the wall, right? Unless you have super flexibility. They're coming off the wall. But keep the edges of your feet on the wall. Keep your heels on the wall. The lower you drop your heels, you got to keep the soles of your feet together, right? The more you're going to feel this, if you need to back it off a little bit, your feet come a little higher with a little pressure off. Make sure your glutes are touching the wall and your heels are touching the wall. And again, just like in that last pose, you can do whatever you want with your hands. Maybe they're coming out long, maybe they're going overhead, maybe they're just resting on your sides. Maybe you're using them, taking them, pressing your knees open even more, right? Now, if you don't have any wall space, here's your option here. You're just doing your basic reclining bound ankle. Laying on the mat, bringing the soles of the feet together, and again, whatever you want to do with your hands. This is the second pose in a row we're doing. It's opening the inner thighs. Maybe those are starting to talk to you. Starting to feel a little sensation there. That's okay. In the end, we just breathe through that sensation. Send your breath to your inner thighs as you exhale. Tell those spots that are aching to release. So that's what they are doing, right? As you're lying, they're releasing. Maybe it's not your inner thighs, it could be your outer thighs, it could be your hips. A lot of things going on when we're in reclining bound ankle. That's why it's such a great pose, whether we do it flat on our back or we do it on the wall. Wherever you're feeling that sensation the most, wherever you're starting to feel so much sensation by this point right now, we've been here about a minute or so, that you're like, I don't know if I want to stay here, right? That's your spot. If you're trying to start, if you're starting to think about squirming around, see if that spot doesn't talk to you anymore, that's when you need your breath. Send your breath to that place. Use your breath. We're going to take another minute here. So let yourself settle in. Now you're gonna push your feet back up to the sky, right? So we're back in that regular leg of the wall pose. What we're gonna do from here, we're gonna do our, I call it eye of the needle when we do it on the mat, but here, right, you know, we don't really use that eye. They call it reclining pigeon sometimes too. It's a reclining pigeon on the wall. So here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna bend into your knees so your feet come to the wall, right? And then you're gonna take your right foot, bring your right ankle against your left inner thigh. Now you can adjust your left foot, right? the more you drop it down, the more it's going to push your right leg towards the body, the more you're going to feel that sensation in your right hip, right? If I take my left foot a little higher, I'm getting a little less sensation. So you adjust it by how far that left foot comes up and down the wall, right? Then you can relax your hands. They don't have to get involved. You're still feeling that deep sensation in your right hip, right? So wherever you are, all good. Now, I'm going to show you how to do it if you don't have a wall. If we don't have a wall, we're just laying on the mat. You take your right heel, put it on top of your left ankle, let that right knee fall open, and then you pull that left leg in towards you. We call it eye of the needle when we're on the mat, right? Because you take your right hand, slide it in the eye of that needle. So you take it around the outside of your left thigh, bring your left hand around, or around the inside of your left thigh, your left hand comes to the outside of your left thigh, and you're pulling that leg in. Okay? When you're on the mat, it's more of an adjustment with that left leg. The more you pull it in towards your body, the more you're going to feel it. The more you let it come away, the more you back it off. When you're on that wall, it's your foot. Right? The higher it goes, the less sensation you feel. The more you drop that left foot, the more sensation you feel. So whether you're on the wall or on the mat, okay, find your place, that place where you're feeling a lot of sensation in the hip. But not so much sensation that you can't hang out here for the 2 minutes. When you're ready here, you're gently going to let that right heel slide off. And you're just going to come back, put that right foot on the wall. And then we're going to go the other way. So you're going to take that left ankle, put your left ankle on top of your right knee. So your left knee is falling open to the side. And again, here, like I said, if you need to, bring that right foot higher on the mat. It makes it a little less intense. You can keep dropping that right foot down as much as you can. Still keep that foot flat on the wall. It makes it more intense. Whatever you want to do with your hands. Okay, if you're not on the wall, but again, you're just that eye of the needle pose with your left knee on top of your right ankle. Sometimes on the left side, a little more sensation in the left hip. Okay, so notice that. Maybe you have less sensation in the left hip. Adjust for that. Right? Maybe your foot went a little higher when you were on your right hip. Now it drops down lower so you can get the same amount of sensation. Maybe it started out a little lower on the right side. It's got to go up a little higher so you can even out the sensation here. You don't have to look the same as you look on the other side, but I want you to be feeling the same amount of sensation that you were feeling on the other side. Right? Let's take 2 minutes here. Now from here, we're going to come out of this. You're just going to let your right foot slide back up the wall. Bring the left foot to join it. So come to that regular legs of the wall here. Now we're going to do one last thing here before we twist, right? We're going to do this on each side. So this is called half dragonfly. And what you're going to do here, you're going to push your right foot, bend into your right knee so your right foot's against the wall, right? And then you're going to let that right knee fall open so the knife edge of the pinky toe side of your right foot is against the wall. And then from there, you're going to take this left foot, you're going to let that left foot start to slide out as low as it wants to come, keeping your calf, your heel against the wall. So it looks like this. Again, you can do whatever you want with your hands, be against the sides, be overhead, they can rest on your belly, use them on the legs. Okay. Now, if you don't have a wall, right, you have two options here. Really, to approximate this best, you'd be doing fallen tree, left leg, get long, and just take that right sole of the foot against your left inner thigh, let your right knee fall open, come right here, right? Or maybe you want to do a half happy baby, keep that left foot on the ground. You grab a hold of your right leg as you kick it up into the air, pulling that right knee down towards the outside of your right shoulder. So those are easy variations where you're getting the same stretch if you don't have a wall. It's kind of like we're in that wide forward fold if you're on the wall, right? That wide straddle foot, I should say, right? As you let that left leg fall open, it might come open a little more, a little more, a little more, and it's okay, right? Maybe your right knee starts to come open a little more, a little more, a little more. Let it gradually happen. You don't have to force it, but you're not fighting against it. Let your body gradually take just a little more space here. Slowly let that left foot come back up. Bring the right foot up to join it so you're back in that regular lift of the wall pose. And then from here, we're going to go kick that on the other side. So you're going to bend into your left knee, put your left foot against the wall, and then push that left knee open so the knife edge of the pinky toe side of your left foot is against the wall. That knee is starting to fall open. And then let your right foot fall open, right leg, I should say. Let it come as low as it wants to. Here. Again, if you're not on the wall, there's your options. Taking that right leg long, either way, and either just letting that left knee fall open with the sole left foot against the right inner thigh and that fallen tree, or taking that left foot up, grabbing a hold of it with your left hand, and then you'll have a happy day.
Let that right leg come all the way back up. Bring the left foot up to join it. So back in this leg at the wall. The last thing we're going to do here, we're not going to stay in these for very long, right? We're going to take some twists. You're going to let your feet come down until both feet are against the wall. Again, your choice, they can be super low, they can be a little bit higher. Let your arms come out wide, like wings in that T position, or cactus arms if you'd rather, right? And then just let your knees come over to the right. Let your feet slide all the way down. So the soles of your feet are pressing into the mat. Glutes are pressing into the mat. Maybe your right knee comes all the way down to the ground. Maybe not. Just stay here for about four breaths. Keep that left shoulder anchored to the ground. And then as you inhale, bring your feet back up so your feet are back on the wall. And then you're going to let your knees fall over to the left as you look to the right. Keep your feet against the wall, glutes against the wall as you look over your right shoulder. Slide your feet back up, right? And we're coming back up into that leg at the wall pose. Now, for a lot of people, this is really comfortable, especially after everything we just did. You might want to stay here for your Shavasana because it feels really relaxing and lovely. If that's what it feels like for you, then stay here. If you're like, I've had enough of the wall, then don't stay on the wall, right? You can roll over to one side or the other and come around and just find your mat. You can lay flat on your mat, roll to your side or your belly. Right, bend your knees, however you want to take your Shavasana. Right, you take it that way, make it perfectly comfortable to you. And get a position that's going to allow you to find that quiet mind. Whether you're lying long on your mat, or you're lying with your legs at the wall, or you're lying on your belly. The key to Shavasana is not emptying your mind of all thoughts. If you try to empty your mind of all thoughts, I'll tell you right now, it's not going to work. Right? The thoughts will just keep coming at you. When you're trying not to have them, they'll come harder. They'll come faster. So instead of trying to empty your mind of all thoughts, just allow whatever thoughts want to come into your mind. The key is that as soon as you notice that you're having that thought, acknowledge it, and then just release it. And make room for the next one. When the next thought comes into your mind, you might get the same thought, which is what happens when we're anxious about something, or we're dwelling on something. It's okay. Whatever that next thought is, you do the same thing. You acknowledge it, release it, make room for the next thought. When it comes, you acknowledge it, you release it, make room for the next thought. Eventually, you can get yourself to a place where those thoughts are just floating in and out of your mind, like ocean waves. And when you get there, that's your true quiet of the mind. Thank you.
slowly. Start to come back into the room. Wiggle your fingers, your toes. Feeling that angry sensation that comes with a quiet mind. If you're up on the wall, you're just going to bend into your knees so your feet are onto the wall, and then let yourself roll to one side or the other in a fetal position. Right? If you're already laying on your back, you'll roll over onto your side. We're going to take our time there, right wherever you are, come to your side. Allow yourselves a few breaths to reacclimate to our space. And then when you're ready, only when you're ready, you're going to push yourself up to seated, and we'll close here. Right? So we're going to close like always with our two Bhumari breaths, and then an Om. The Bhumari breath, we inhale, we exhale, make no humming sound. The Om is the universal syllable, uses all parts of the throat. Join me in these breaths, or just listen. Let's close our eyes here and inhale together. Open. Bring your hands to heart center. Thank you, all of you, for sharing your energy, your practice with me this evening. The light in me honors the light in each of you. Namaste. Alright. So I will be back Saturday with some slow flow at 10 a.m. So come join me then. Seema, I think. No, Seema or Kelly. I'm not even sure. Somebody will be here tomorrow morning to do some dancing with you at 9:30. So come join them for that. And I'll see you guys all Saturday. Bye.